Hi, I'm Bill Scott, and I'm president of Syracuse Teachers Association. We represent 3,100 union members in the city of Syracuse. We serve 21,000 students in the Syracuse City School District. COVID has presented a lot of challenges to educators. Our main focus as a union has been focusing on the balance of getting kids into school, but keeping staff and students safe along the way. There's been a lot of discussions as we adapt and face the challenges of COVID and try to incorporate ever-shifting guidance on what keeps people safe so that we can get the students back. Because again, our teachers have wanted the students back since the beginning. Our primary focus has been, how do we do that safely? What's helped us as we've gone through these trials is working together as a union, using that union voice, getting the brothers and sisters together to make sure that we are collaborating and with the district and with the county executive and making sure that our voices are heard. Sometimes we found it really challenging that our advocacy was not heard. And what we did in those cases is make sure that our individual voices became a chorus of voices. We had people reach out to the superintendent, the school board, and the county executive to let them know that it wasn't just the union's initiative and agenda alone that was being voiced, but these were the voices and concerns of the people that were on the front lines doing the work. What needs to change as we move forward? We need to make sure that we continue to implement that chorus of voices. It's very important that our leaders, be it the district or be it the county executive, understand that as a union, we are the people on the front line doing that work. We have concerns that need to be addressed and need to be heard. And that if you listen to the concerns of the people on the front line and you work to address them in a time of crisis like this, it offers them the reassurance that they have, that they need, that they deserve to move forward and do the work safely. Without that, people are operating in a vacuum and they're very much nervous and apprehensive about the task at hand. So going forward, let's continue to collaborate. Let's continue to be union strong. Thank you.